Hi, I'm Alex, an engineering manager at Plex. If you've ever wondered how best to set up Plex user accounts for a family living together, you're going to want to watch my video on Plex Home. Plex is a remote company, so I'm lucky that I get to live here in sunny Scotland. But enough about me, I'm here today as part of Plex Pro Week to introduce you to Plex Home. Plex Home is a way to easily manage and switch between different users for all the people that live in your home. It's a great feature for anyone who lives with other people who also use Plex. For example, maybe you have a family and you want your kids to have their own users that only have access to certain content. Or maybe you live with a partner or a roommate and you want to keep both of your viewing histories and recommendations separate. Well, Plex Home is great for lots of uses like those. So today, I'm going to take you through how to set up a Plex Home, the different types of accounts you can have in a home, and how to use PIN codes and auto sign-in for security and convenience. Then we're going to talk about managing what Plex media server content your home users have access to, and some parental control settings that you might find useful for managed users. All right, let's get started. First of all, I'm going to show you how to get to the Plex Home settings if you've never configured your Plex Home before. So from the Plex homepage, I'm going to click Open Plex to launch the web client. Then I'm going to click on my account up here, and then Account Settings, and finally Plex Home. From here, I can create managed users, or I can invite other Plex users to join my home. There are three types of accounts in a Plex Home. There's the home admin, which is you, if you've set up the Plex Home. There are managed accounts, and there are full Plex users. We're going to start by talking about managed accounts. So managed accounts are often used by parents to create an account for their kids. I'm going to set up one now. I'm going to click Create Managed Account, and then I'm going to enter a name here. I'm going to go with John. I can also configure a restriction profile here. This determines the ratings of content that the managed account will have access to. So I can choose from younger kid, older kid, teen, or none. I'm going to select younger kid today. Then we click continue. Now, if you own a Plex media server, you'll be offered the option to share libraries with the new managed account. I'm going to choose to share my movies and my TV shows with John. Next, I click continue. Lastly, I'm going to be given the option of whether I want to allow the managed user to download content, and because I have a tuner connected to my Plex media server, I'm going to be given the option to give them access to my live TV and DVR. I don't want John to have access to the live TV, so I'm going to leave that off, but I'm happy for him to download content onto his devices, so I'm going to leave that enabled. Finally, I click Add. Because I'm adding a user to my Plex Home for the first time, Plex is offering to create a PIN on my account. This is a PIN that will have to be entered to be able to switch to my account. This is useful because I don't want John to easily be able to switch to my account on our TV. So I'm going to create a PIN now. I'm going to go with the extra secure 1234, but you should probably pick something better than that. I'm going to click Save, and that's it. I now have a user in my Plex Home for the first time. Now when I launch Plex on my TV, this is what I'm going to see. The option to choose me or to choose John. And if I choose me, I'll have to enter the PIN code that I set up earlier to be able to get into my account. And I can go up to the user menu here and select Switch User to change to John's account. But what if I have a TV or another device that John doesn't have access to and I just want to use my account all the time? Well, we have a setting that can help with that. I'll switch back to my account first. I just go to my settings and I can choose automatically sign in. Then next time when I launch Plex, it'll stay logged in to the user that was logged in last time. Okay, so we're back in our account settings. Now you might be thinking, what if there's another adult in my house who has their own Plex account? Let's say my husband has his own Plex account. We both have our own Plex friends, and he doesn't want to be associated with my binge watches of the traitors. But we watch Plex on the same TV, so we want to easily switch between our accounts. Well, Plex Home lets us do that by adding another full Plex user. I'm going to click Invite Plex User. I'm going to be given a warning that inviting other users to your home is a security risk because it allows those users to access your account. This is an important thing to be aware of. When you switch between accounts in a Plex Home, you become that user and have full access to everything within their account, including any Plex media service they may have, and their full account information. This means you should only allow your Plex account to be part of a Plex Home where you completely trust the home admin. And while you can set a PIN as a deterrent to other users in your home switching to your account, a PIN should not be considered a replacement for good account security, and you should only be part of a home with others that you trust. Fortunately, my husband does trust me, so we can invite him to our Plex Home. I'm going to enter his username. It'll show me his username here with his profile picture so I know it's him. I'm going to click on him and click continue. Just like when I create a managed user, I'll be asked what libraries on my server I want to give Duncan access to. I'm going to choose all the libraries this time and click continue. Just like when adding a managed user, I'll be given some options here which I can configure, but I'm just going to click continue. On this last page, I'll be asked if I want to add Duncan as a friend, as well as adding him to our Plex Home. With Discover Together features, this means you can see what each other is watching, you can share your watch lists and ratings with each other. I'm going to keep that selected so we can be friends, and I'm going to click send. Now, Duncan will show up on this list, but it'll be marked as awaiting their response. Full accounts have to confirm that they want to be part of a home before they can be used. Now I can see that Duncan has been added to this list, but he needs to confirm that he wants to be part of the Plex Home before I'm able to switch to his account. I'll ask him to go do that now. So now we have a few different accounts in our home. I'm going to show you some of the in-depth controls and settings you have to manage what content users have access to. So let's click on John to edit the settings. If I go to restrictions, we can see that I currently have the restriction profile set to younger kid. I can tweak this and put it at, for example, older kid if I want to give access to higher ratings. But another option that I have if I have a Plex media server is to choose none, save changes, and then I get more controls over what content in my libraries the user has access to. So for example, I can click on movies to get a few different options. I can choose to limit content to specific ratings, I can choose to exclude certain ratings, or I can choose to allow or exclude certain labels. So I can, for example, put a label on all the movies that I want this account to have access to, and then I could choose that label here to give access to only that content. This is useful if you want to dial in access and have more control over the specific content that account has access to. And of course, I can click on TV shows or music if I want to do the same for TV shows or music. This is also where I can go to edit profile settings like the username for John's account or a profile picture if I want to make my user switcher look a little bit nicer. If you want to learn more about Plex Home, you can visit support.plex.tv, where we have a series of articles about Plex Home, how to set up a Plex Home, example setups, and more. So, that's it for today. We've walked through what a Plex Home is, when it's useful, and how to set up and manage one. Hopefully you've learned some useful stuff, and you're now well equipped to make Plex work well for you in your home. Thanks for watching.